Welcome back. Conditions just getting a little bit foggy as we move into the early evening here at the Bezerra di Puni Ice Stadium. This Olympic oval track here in Trentino, hosting the University Speed Skating Championships, and that's our start list for the ladies' mass start. We've got 11 competitors going to head off, so Marin Sarap is in there, and final part of the page belongs to Willemien Knossen of the Netherlands. Yes, chilly conditions, and the foggy conditions not helping either. The athletes just being given their last instructions, each having to wear a safety helmet. The number on the side will allow us, well, I hope, some chance of identification, although not always easy when you're away from the skaters on the mass starts. So 16 laps of skating, and in amongst those 16 laps, three sprint sections, 5 points if you take the sprint section, 3 if you finish second, 1 if you finish in third position. But if you cross the line at the end of those 16 laps in the lead, you get a straight 60 points. If you cross the line in second, it's 40. And crossing the line in third, it's 20. So sometimes those sprints will be factored in, but we've got a very slow tactical start to this race. So there's an opportunity for somebody, maybe one of the lower seeds, to grab a name for themselves here. There's a couple of fairly quick athletes in this group that might fancy a dart at the first sprint. And very slowly through the opening lap. Our cat and mouse at the moment, Bortolotti for Italy in first place, 51.66 seconds for the first 400. That's our ice skate, but it is tactical. It's all about waiting for position, waiting to see who's going to make the break. And at the moment, Anna-Marie Bort, one of the favourites for the medals, is just keeping a careful eye on this. Bohr in the number 4 safety helmet. Moves it a little wider, just offering the track. But being given some very close attention there by number 5, Marin Sarap. The Estonian, well, she knows which side her bread is buttered. She is very definitely trying to track Bohr here. And nobody giving anything away at the moment. You are allowed to place your hands on the athlete in front just to keep your distance and keep it safe, but you can't boost them and you certainly can't interfere with their progress. And at the moment, Bohr not really being given a challenge. Now, opportunities here developing. Bohr has decided to drop to the back of the pack. That's left Willem Knossen in top position, and just behind her, Giulia Lollobrigida, the Italian ace here at these championships. Lollobrigida might fancy a dart at the sprint. Just in behind Lollobrigida is Bortolotti again, who led it out round that first lap. Gradual ramping up of the pace. They're starting to move now, and here we go. The first sprint. Knossen fancies it. It's going to be very tight, but I think it's going to be Lollobrigida, you know. It is. And Giulia Lollobrigida takes the 5 points. Bortolotti, the fellow Italian, taking 3, but Willemien Knossen keeps the pace going after the sprint. So single point in the bank for Knossen. And now away and clear at the top of the field, and we're starting to lose Marin Sarap. I'm not sure she's going to finish this race with 11 laps to go. Well, Knossen, if she keeps this distance between her and the rest of the field, she's going to pick up some more sprint points on the way. But remember, a group of athletes working together, just like a peloton in cycling, can work far more effectively closing down an athlete that is out there on their own in front. Carson's going to have to have a little think about how she wants to play this. Here comes the push from the chasing pack. They will share the workload to get back to Knossen. And remember, Anna-Marie Boer will have to contribute to that. So Knossen in the lead as we go through the 4 minute mark. Now 16 laps is a long way when you're skating it at this pace. Sometimes it can be a lot quicker. 9 laps to go. Belt signalling to let the racers know there's another sprint on, so points to be picked up, and I think Knossen has just picked herself up 5 there. So first sprint, she picked up the single, kept the pace going. She's out in the lead on her own. She's taken the 5 off this one. She's going to surely take the next sprint as well. That's when things are going to get tricky for Knossen. That's when the chasing pack will really work hard to close her down. But they're going to have to be careful not to let her get too far away here. At the moment, the work being done by Jessica Merkins, the Netherlands, along with Bortolotti. And that's confirmation of that last sprint, 5 points going the way of Knossen. Well, if she wins the next sprint, that's 11 points in the bank, but that's going to count for nothing if she can't then find a way into the top part of the race. And once this group of chasing athletes decides to go and decides to get moving, they are going to travel very quickly indeed. Still Jessica Merkins exerting a certain amount of control over that pack. Anna-Marie Boer alongside her. Well, ideally, if they can time everything right here, then they could end up with a 1-2-3, the Dutch, but the rest of the field have got other ideas. They're not going to let that happen. And it's Kasia Wozniak of Poland that decides to ramp it up and take it out. She's had enough of Knossen away and clear. And Wozniak being chased down by Jessica Merkins, who's closed it up pretty quickly. And they're going to use Wozniak now as Knossen makes her way towards another pretty easy 5 points. But there will surely be a point towards the end of this race where that closing group will just simply swallow Knossen up. 5 laps to go then, that's still a long way. 5 ovals of 400 metres. And still the work being done by Wozniak. Break, mini break forming with that particular group of athletes. Wozniak in there, Merkins in there, Anna-Marie Boer, one of the favourites for gold, in there. So feel still things good for her. And I think Alessia Chenega as well, the Russian, is there. They are going to get to Knossen very, very shortly. Not in time for the sprint points, but that's irrelevant now. Knossen is going to be swallowed up by this chasing pack. There's another 5 points in the bank. Wozniak picks up the 3. Merkins picks up the 1. And looking very keen, Merkins moves to the front. Wozniak just slipstreaming her, and behind them, Anna Pristalova of Russia. And Knossen is gone. So that initial work from her not paying off. Although she has cancelled out other challenges as well from other nations and left the door very firmly open. 2 Dutch skaters then in this breakout pack of 5. At the back there, Alessia Chenega just keeping an eye on things alongside Anna-Marie Boer. So Chenega and Boer not wanting too much to do with the speed at the moment. And they're going to get caught by the pack they just broke from, although Boer has other ideas. Little false break from Boer, just to see who fancies it. And the 2 Russians tuck in with her. Pristalova just behind her. Chenega in 3rd. And Wozniak still part of that group, as well as Jessica Merkins. It's their turn to keep a very close eye on the front markers. Not the most conducive conditions to skate in this evening. the chasing pack, looking slightly laboured there is Eliska Drimalova. She's already skated a lot, the Czech Republic skater at these championships. Into the last 400 metres, and Anna Marie Boer has a clear run here. Moves herself nicely into position just ahead of Pristalova, but from the back comes Alicia Chinaga. Chinaga, the Russian, going wide to get in position. Wozniak just behind her, and Merkins is going to struggle to find a way through here. She's going to have to be very careful coming round this last bend, but Anna Marie Boer has it all her own way at the moment. The goal is waiting for the Dutch woman. It's going to be gold for Anna Marie Boer, the favourite at the start of this race to take it. He's going to take this one home. She's done it brilliantly, and just behind her, Chinaga dives for the line ahead of Merkins. So Russia get the silver, and Merkins makes it to Dutch on the podium. That final sprint lap for the big points gives 60 to Boer. The 20 points going to Merkins, along with her two from the other sprints for third positions, making it 22. And that's not going to be enough to overhaul Alicia Chinaga's straight 40 for the last sprint. That was a great piece of work from Boer. And tactically very astute all the way through what was a highly tactical race. That was very tricky indeed. Wozniak then just missing out in fourth position. Good effort from her. But there's your 1-2-3. Boer, Chinaga and Merkins, the Russian, just getting in between the two Dutch women. Well, decent mass start race, that one. Interesting to watch. Interesting development. But in the end, it was the power and tactical nous of Anna Marie Boer that allowed her to win that one. And once she had a clear run into that last lap, she controlled things very, very nicely indeed. Got some of your highlights from the race. That was Marin Sarat just losing her way. That was the initial break from Knossen. Without concern, without worry, the chasing pack just gradually ramped it up. They left Knossen to her own devices. She was eventually overhauled. That was that first little break from Boer to go past her compatriot. And then Boer just kept injecting little bits of pace until the final go. That was a good straight 400 metres worth of power from Boer to claim the medal, and a decent charge for the line from Chinaga, meaning Russia pick up that second place, just denying Merkins for the bronze, and Merkins in turn just denying Wozniak and Pristalova. Good race then from the Dutch, and straight over to Knossen to say well done. Good try, good try. So a really enjoyable race. Let's hope the men's mass start is as entertaining as the women's. That's coming up after the break. Stay with us.
Follow the World University Championships. FISU, today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.